under the Social Assistance Grants for Empowerment (SAGE) program implemented by the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, the senior citizens of 80 years and above are entitled to a monthly pay of 25,000 shillings to facilitate their social well-being. However, during a sensitization meeting organized by the Uganda Parliamentary Forum on Social Protection today, MPs expressed their disappointment with the government for delaying to pay the older persons since mid last year.
Let the government come up clearly and explain, because I believe there is money and the government is in the right position to explain this, and the Minister of Finance should come out clearly and say why there is this delay. If there is no money, can we look for money on the floor of Parliament?
Already we have arrears to be paid in this financial year. Now next year we are going to have about 77 billion shortfall. So we are wondering, how are they going to survive, or how are they going to pay old persons?
I think this is the right time for us to make sure that we appropriate the budget so that this program is kept on. If we do not follow this, a curse from these elderly people is very, very bad for us, and we shall end up perishing before them.
According to Stephen Kasaija, the head of the Program Management Unit at the Ministry of Gender, government has unpaid arrears for the fourth quarter of the financial year 2020-2021 amounting to 36.08 billion shillings for 270,203 beneficiaries. Kasaija said that whereas 120.7 billion shillings has been allocated for the financial year 2022-2023, there's no commitment from the Ministry of Finance to offset the arrears.
So we had come up with a proposal to our colleagues in finance that possibly we use the current budget, clear that backlog, then if there is a shortfall, that's what we carry forward. Maybe it could be covered in the supplementary, and then we address it. But finance thought, no, let us first keep that, and it should be reflected in the areas for the next budget.
I have seen suggestions to buy cars, escort cars, I don't know cars for who. Fleet. Is this necessary? Fleet of vehicles. Creating conflicts in communities. You can now see how tall the cultural institutions are because of these small monies that the government has put. And to me, I think we need to stand firm and say no. Before monies are available for these older persons, we should not create other, you know, expenditure lines.
The chairperson of the parliamentary forum, Flavia Kabahenda Rabuhoro, has urged MPs to use the platform to persuade government to bring a supplementary budget to clear the pending arrears. She rallied them not to approve the supplementary budget, which government plans to introduce in parliament very soon if SAGE arrears are not catered for.
This government, on affirmative action, pledged to look after the vulnerable persons in this country, inclusive of the older persons. We are expected to finance, advocate for financing of SAGE.
MPs and other stakeholders are also piling pressure on government to lower the eligibility age from 80 years to at least 70 to increase the number of beneficiaries. They also want the money raised from the current 25,000 shillings to at least 35,000 to match up the high cost of living.
If this age can be reduced, can be lowered from 80 to 70, at least that is reasonable, because at 70 a person can access this money. And also the nature, the amount of money they are being paid is too little. At least we need to increase. These are our elderly. A society without elderly means that it is not a society, because we need these people to guide us.
There are errors that were made while they were registering people for their national IDs, and it is that national ID registration that is always being followed. Some people had their ages being reduced below what they actually have.
Lowering the eligibility age from 80 to 70 will see a total of 764,945 beneficiaries covered from the current 358,420, and that would require an additional budget of 158 billion shillings. Since its inception in 2010, the SEJ program has benefited 393,284 older persons to a tune of 479.7 billion shillings. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news. 10.